What is happening, YouTube? So today I just thought I'd take you through a usual day in the life for me. So this morning, it's already 1 o'clock, so it's around lunchtime. Actually, this morning I've been waiting for Friesman to wake up in the morning, and he got up at like 12:30, and turns out he wanted to go for a run, not train. So we're meant to train together and do some filming, but he's gonna go train later on. So I thought I would take you through a session on my own, and I'll try and film it in the gym by myself. So not gonna be as like, I guess, cinematic and cool, but yeah, I mean, I'll try and be informative and show you guys a thing or two. So anyway, I'm gonna leave the house now, and yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit. Alright, so just walked in the gym, and I've just been informed that gym's quiet, so I was hoping it was quiet. Came at the quietest time of the day, which is, 2 o'clock now on a Saturday, so everyone's Christmas shopping. Yeah, so we're heading there now. Gonna smash out this hamstring session, so I'm pumped.
Seems like all these girls are perfect. All these girls are perfect. In LA. In LA. They've got so much there to purchase. All those labels on their purses. In LA. No place I've seen compares to California. There's nothing but angels out there. A place filled with angels, I swear.
So you would have noticed I had a plate on the ground just behind me that I was standing on. That just allows for an extra range of motion at the bottom of the movement. So because I'm so tall, normally with my arm length I can go a little bit deeper. So I like to put the plate on the ground there just for that added extra range of motion to get full stretch. And yeah, I'm just doing 20 a side, so I don't really need to go that much heavier than that. Just purely because as soon as you start going heavier, your lower back started taking a lot more of the strain of the movement. So I just want to be able to purely focus on isolating my hamstrings. But yeah, I find that as soon as I start going heavier than a plate and a half, my lower back starts to come into the movement. So to avoid that, I generally go a little bit lighter. So yeah, I'm just doing 3 working sets here, and then we'll move on to some lying hamstring curls. So I've just had a message from Friesma. He just said he's coming in to come film me. So yeah, it turns out that it's going to be a good session and we're going to get some good footage. So anyway, he'll be here pretty soon, hopefully, and yeah, we'll get a good editing. So, all right, people, you're in luck. My boy Freezy has just arrived. My cameraman for...
You guys are in luck.
All right, so now the second exercise, we're doing a different variation of the stiff leg deadlift with the cable. So I'll show you guys now. This is another great exercise. Different exercise, yeah, obviously your hamstrings, but also your glutes as well, at the top of the movement when you really squeeze. So, not the most pleasing exercise to do in the gym, but...
They say come and join us, the weather's much warmer. Heaven's California. Heaven's California. Heaven's California.
Yeah, that is just like constant tension all the way down on your hamstrings, and then at the top of the movement when you squeeze your glutes, like you feel the like you're burning. It really hurts, so another good exercise for your hammies and glutes. So probably do like 3 sets here. We've already done 3 sets there. Normally what I like to do is I'll pyramid the weight up, so start lower, go higher and higher with the weight. Then as I start to fatigue, I'll reduce the weight. So it's like a pyramid kind of scheme with the rep range and the weight. So, and always with my legs, I generally go higher volume with everything I do. I don't go excessively heavy, I always focus on a strict form. So you see me really isolating and squeezing throughout the movement. You don't see me jerking the weight around or anything like that. So I guess that's how I kind of develop my legs. Like my quads are at this stage quite overpowering compared to my hamstrings. So that's why I'm prioritizing the hammies at the moment. Just splitting them up. So next exercise we're doing, I'm doing called a prone leg curl, but this is a pre-core movement. It's slightly, obviously slightly different, but basically the same thing, like about 45. So again, not going crazy heavy or anything like that. Just want to be able to squeeze and like focus on contracting and holding the negative portion of the movement. So I'm probably going to go between 8 and 12 reps now.
They say come and join us, the weather's much warmer. Heaven's California, heaven's California, heaven's California.
Starting this exercise, but I found that just doing those stretching exercises at the beginning, so the stiff leg deadlifts and the other cable variation, you stretch your hamstrings out, so you find that you can gauge your hamstrings a lot better on a fixed machine like this one. So that I just felt it way more than I normally would. So give it a go and just do some like stretching movements at the start, and you'll find it can really engage your hamstrings a lot more. And yeah, so we'll do three, four sets here. So next one we're going to do is a pre-core leg curl, single-legged. So again, pretty simple exercise. You just want to focus squeezing at the top of the movement and having that slow eccentric. So like 3 seconds the way down, and then 2 seconds on the concentric, which is on the way up. So yeah, we'll show you guys how to do that now. Get the old hamstring out.
Pop it out, bro.
Tell me if it's popping.
Tell the people about the great material of these shorts.
Yeah, so these oatmeal shorts, I've got quite large legs, as you can tell.
Yeah.
No, not really, but these are a medium, right?
And they're very stretchy.
They're quite stretchy, so if you've got bigger legs, you'll find that they're really flexible, they're really comfortable, and the material's not super thick, so it doesn't get really like hot in the gym. You don't sweat, like you don't see any sweat patches in these. You find that the fabric is quite, how would you say, like it's not super absorbent, so it's breathable, I guess is the word for it. So
yeah,
you don't really sweat much in your shorts.
There's nothing
worse than wearing grey pants or grey shorts and seeing sweat patches.
Yeah. Actually, you're right, I've never noticed it. You don't see like sweat and
yeah.
Number two,
so yeah, pretty straightforward exercise really, just really focusing on squeezing at the top and holding it, and you'll feel the squeeze, trust me, it's quite painful.
Yow. Blank face, amazing grace, goddamn girl, goddamn girl, use your angel wings, no hands girl.
I'm just aiming for like at least 8 to 10 reps on each leg, and just about 3 sets as well for that, so. And we're gonna finish up on some lunges now, so I'll show you guys that. What I'm gonna do is just gonna follow the path, go all the way to the end, then come back. I'm only doing about 12s here, so not super heavy, but we might increase the weight as we go. And we'll probably do about 3 sets of this as well to finish off.
Ham and a lamb, girl, you know, skirt, skirt. Lift your skirt, skirt, give me work, work. That's missionary like church, church. Legs open like pearly gates. In a thug mansion, get a thug pass. Without Alizé, bow down to pray. I burn an ounce a day, puff, puff, fast. Those rosaries like Catholics. Might cop the road, just crash it. You can rock the rollie while I hit it. Hey, you can rock the rollie while I hit it. Yeah. Schoolboy in a new toy, with a new toy, a whole down fig. You was looking for heaven and you found it. You was looking for heaven and you found it. Yo. No place I've seen compares to California. There's nothing.
You gonna go heavier, bro?
I think I'll go heavier, yeah.
You will? Oh, is it actually? I thought you were gonna be struggling there.
Alright, guys, so that's the hamstring workout done for you. Something a little bit different, hopefully, and I don't wanna be doing things and showing you guys stuff that you already know. So, with my channel, I wanna try and show you stuff that's different, something that you can really get value from. And yeah, hopefully you can give it a try in your own time. So I'm going to finish up here. I'm going to grab some grilled after this and get a bit of a feed, because Saturday is normally my day where I kind of enjoy myself. So yeah, we'll catch you guys in a bit.
I feel better up here.
Yeah, same, mate.
It's not weird down there, right?
Yeah.
Imagine doing a burger challenge up here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You should have.
Me and Friesma were thinking about doing a 10K challenge, and we're meant to be doing it this weekend. But I don't know, you're probably not as hungry this weekend, eh?
Yeah, I mean, I've been like fucking having blasting meals. Like, I've been just
fasting and like not eating fucking meals.
Yeah.
My stomach just couldn't. I'll get like 4,000. I'll struggle to get 4,000 calories right now. Yeah. Honestly.
It's like you almost have to like train your body to prepare yourself for the 10K challenge. So well, we're both not ready, but we definitely do it.
We'll
like,
do it in the new year.
So yeah, stay tuned for that, guys. And if you have got any other suggestions, let us know.
Do you get some of the chicken?
Yep. So me and my boy Frizzy, we are going to celebrate tonight. I booked a table for two for us at Hurricane, so pretty cute.
That's fucking gay, bro. What are we doing?
I know, right?
What are we doing? Jim says Christmas party, that's what we're doing.
Yeah, we've got the two employees here, so we've got to celebrate somehow. But anyway, so I've got to head out tonight, and yeah, this is what we're wearing. So time to go enjoy the night and eat some good food. Probably not yet, we're just gonna have a little think.
Well,
you can get a starter.
Need a drink,
eh? Oh, I need to eat first.
You need to eat first?
Yeah.
Okay,
okay. Because I'm so hungry.
Give us 2 minutes and we'll just order our mains first.
Yeah.
Okay, sweet.
Just because I've got an empty stomach, bro, and it hit me straight away. Like, I'll get drunk off one drink.
That's what we want.
That's legitimately, like, I never drink, so it hit me hard.
Did you have one at the Culture Kings thing?
No, I didn't even drink there, bro.
You didn't have one?
I can't even remember the last time I had a drink.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Like, I'm thinking off the top of my head right now. Like, it was well before comp, which is 16, like, what is that, like, half a year now?
Yeah.
When I think about it, bro, I've actually forgotten what it is like to drink.
Yeah, I wanna see you with a drink in here. Hey, we can get two in here, I'm driving.
There you go, the good influence over here. We seem to be tracking the service around here. We've had about 5 minutes to sit down and we've been approached three times to ask people what we want for our mains. So Freezy over here needs a little bit more time.
I'm feeling rushed.
You don't want to feel rushed, bro.
Fuck out of me.
This menu is quite extensive, so I already know I'm probably gonna go what I got last week, which was in the New York cut steak. So pretty decent size with a side of potato and some veggies, nice and healthy. But I don't know, I'd be keen to get some ribs as well. Ribs, it's a hard choice deciding between ribs and steak.
Yeah,
it's a really tough one because the ribs here are damn good, man. Like, pork ribs, you can't go wrong.
Yeah.
Like, I think you'd be very satisfied with some ribs, so.
I never get ribs, you see, so that's, you know, I'm just.
It's one of those things where if you never get it, it's like getting it.
It's like mum, when I go to dinner with mum, she'll get ribs and I'll just have a couple of hers, you know?
Oh, okay, yeah.
And it's always good, but I've never just got it myself.
A full rack. You never got a full rack, eh?
No, I've never done it.
I think you should give it a crack.
Yeah, I'm so nervous, but I think you're right.
I think I'm guarantee you will not be disappointed.
Okay, Jay.
And beef ribs?
There's three choices, beef, lamb, or pork ribs.
Pork ribs.
Pork is the one?
You never get any other one with pork.
Okay.
It's an easy decision right there. Okay. And then you can either get chips or potato.
Okay. Should I get a half or a full?
A full? But dude, you get a full rack.
Okay, I'll get a full rack.
Because it's only like a little bit extra.
Okay.
And you get the full rack.
I'll get the full rack.
And then if you don't like it, if you can't finish it, just take one.
Yeah.
But you'll finish it.
Okay.
That's cool. Okay, I think I've helped him decide. So it has arrived and told you it was a big fella.
That's like, how did you convince me to get that? That's
cute. Because you're prepping for the challenge, bro.
Anything else?
That's it for the moment, man. Cheers.
Enjoy.
Thanks, bro.
That's bigger than what it normally is, bro. So maybe it's because it's an early night. I don't know.
Maybe they saw me on my vlog camera. They know I've got 27,000 subscribers.
Yeah. My steak is a little bit smaller than what it normally would be, but it's all right. You probably won't finish all your ribs anyways. Or will he?
Bro, like.
Oh, people, it's the time to enjoy this feed, and I'll let you know if he finishes it. You did it, bro. You polished it all off.
I did it. You know, I gave Jay two little ribs, actually, but I could have polished those.
Guys had these two here. Just those two, so you've done really well. I'm proud of you.
It's time for donut time.
Alright everyone, so just got home and I only got frozen yogurt. I didn't get donut time just because I'm trying to keep it relatively clean. And I told you guys I'm doing a mini cut, so I'm still tracking calories, but I will take you through my mini cut with you over the next 2 weeks before I go away on my holiday. And if you guys have any questions or queries about online coaching, be sure to shoot me an email in my description box below. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one.